Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're continuing once again with our Love Notes Q&A from my latest Love Notes class that I held here in Perth for Al Maghrib Institute. The question, is jealousy healthy? If so, what is acceptable and what is too far? Alhamdulillah. It's a tough question that. Jealousy is a natural emotion. Animals are jealous, all animals. They have some form of jealousy and covetousness and in one shape, way or another. And this is something that was described by the Prophet ﷺ for some of the best of human beings who lived amongst him. So in the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ, there's a narration similar to it in Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ, he said to Aisha, one day, Aisha narrates, he woke up in the middle of the night, put on his clothes, ارْتَدَى ثِيَابَهُ ثُمَّ خَرَجْ. And he left the house. وَلَمْ يُخْبِرْنِي. He didn't tell me where he's going. He didn't tell me earlier when he got up. He didn't wake me up to tell me I'm leaving. And Aisha, you know, being a loving wife, she was jealous. Where's the Prophet going? So I said to him, who's he going to see? Is it another one of his wives? Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. She says, so I got agitated. I got really upset, really angry. And part of the narration, you know, mentions that she threw things about. You know, she was angry. She tossed a couple of things around. فَلَمَّا رَجَعَ رَأَى مَا أَصْنَعَ. Aisha says, when he returned, he saw what I had done to the place. فَقَالَ لِي وَضَحِقْ. He smiled at me, laughed at, you know, and he said to me, يَا عَائِشَ مَا لَكِ أَوَقَدْ غِرْتِ. Aisha, what's wrong with you? Are you jealous? فَقُلْتُ كَيْفَ لَا يَغَارُ مِثْلِي عَلَى مِثْلِكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. And I said, oh, Messenger of Allah, how can someone as simple as me, I'm just, you know, Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, you know who she is, how can someone as simple as me, in her words, not be jealous over someone like you? You're Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَضَحِكَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال أَوَقَدْ جَاءَكِ شَيْطَانِ. Aisha, did your shaitan come and overcome you? Did your shaitan, you know, cause you to go this far? فَقُلْتُ أَوَّ مَعِي شَيْطَانِ. She said, I said, oh, Messenger of Allah, do I have a shaitan? Like, I have a personal shaitan? فَقَالَ بَلَى. He said, yes, you have a shaitan. She said, مَعِي وَلَّ مَعَ كُلِّ إِنسَانِ. Is it just me or everyone's got one of their own? فَقَالَ مَعَ كُلِّ إِنسَانِ. قُلْتُ وَمَعَكَ أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I said, with every human being, even, oh, Messenger of Allah, even you? فَقَالَ بَلَى وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَعَانَنِي عَلَيْهِ فَأَسْلَمَ. فَلَا يَأْمُرَنِي إِلَّا بِخَيْرٍ. He said, yes, even I have a shaitan that was assigned to me, but, وَلَكِنْ, but, Allah allowed me to overcome him, overpower him. فَأَسْلَمْ. So he submitted, or he became a Muslim. It's one of the two interpretations according to Imam al-Nawawi. Either the shaitan became a Muslim, or he submitted, he can't say anything negative to the Prophet ﷺ. فَلَا يَأْمُرَنِي إِلَّا بِخَيْرٍ. He can only call me to that which is good. Now that's a foundational hadith regarding the question that you're asking, my dear brother or sister. Jealousy is there. So the Prophet ﷺ doesn't initially condemn the jealousy of Aisha radiallahu anha because it's a natural emotion. The second wife in the Arabic language, her name is Dara, meaning it comes from the word darar, harm. That was always the psychology of another woman, you know, that I have another, my husband, you know, he has someone else. And that meant she's there to harm me. So that was always there. So even amongst the wives of the Prophet, the best of the best, there was that, you know, competition and jealousy. Umm Salama radiallahu anha, Aisha radiallahu anha, Safiyya bint Huyay radiallahu anha, Hafsa, they used to vie for the attention and love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So jealousy is not something that is uncommon. It is a natural emotion. The problem, of course, is, which is what you've zeroed in on your question, what of jealousy is acceptable? And what of jealousy is condemnable? So here you notice the Prophet ﷺ attributed the overacting on jealousy as being from the shaitan. So it's one thing that you have a tenderness and a love and you have a care and you want more attention, you know, all this kind of thing. It's another thing where you become possessive, where you become domestically violent, where you become controlling, where you become inquisitive to a degree that becomes overbearing and overburdening. Where'd you go? When are you coming? How long? For who? When, or, you know, and it's just unending and it's exhausting, not just for the person being questioned, but you asking. And therefore, you know, you can find yourself imprisoned or putting someone in prison who you love or feeling you're in a prison of overbearing, uncommon love, unnatural love, by having that kind of perspective. So I'm going to give you three things that I hope can help you. First is, whatever you ask of someone, be prepared to be able to answer similar to it. So if you can't ask your husband that kind of question, and you know, if he asked me that, I'd be upset. Then it's not a question really about you asking the same thing. So whatever you want to know, you must be able to provide similar kind of information in a similar circumstance. So if you find it awkward that every time you go out, somebody, where are you going? How long are you? That kind of thing, then don't do the same in return. Keep that in mind. And if you say, I can ask what I'm the man. No, that's not how our deen works. And here you see Aisha radiallahu anha questions the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and she shows her displeasure of the Prophet leaving without asking. And it's a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he was a person who looked after the happiness of his family. In fact, Allah tells us in the Quran, a chapter revealed in the Quran called At-Tahrim, the prohibition. Ya ayyuha an-nabiyyu lima tuharrimu ma ahallallahu lak, O Messenger of God, O Prophet of God, of Allah, why have you prohibited for you that which is permissible to you in accordance to the laws of Allah? Tabtaghi martata azwajik, you've done this to win favor of your wives. So there's a Prophet of Allah, he made something he enjoyed, which is a certain kind of drink, haram upon himself, that he wouldn't touch it, wouldn't eat it, wouldn't drink it, because they said it smelled bad, and it wasn't, you know, it was just, it wasn't a reality. And he said, I'll never drink it again, only because he didn't want his wives to be at discomfort. So think of that before we make those kind of silly kind of comments. I can ask, you don't ask me that. I'm the man, I can ask those kind of questions. No, that's not how our faith works. The second thing is, so the first principle is, be willing to give what you're asking for. The second thing is, repetition does not necessarily mean you're going to get an answer. So asking over and over and over and over again becomes an act of hostility, and it can become a form of abuse, where you become so repetitive and so incessant about one particular thing that now you've lost any attempt at kindness, and it's only about proving a point or getting, you know, some kind of justification answer. And that's really one of the places where you get a lot of brothers who turn off from their wives, and they begin to tune out the voice, tune out the presence. Now, it's not right, but I can tell you it is something that you hear often in my job as a counselor and speaking to people to try to bring them back together, that, you know, she's just got to stop. She's just got to see, I don't want to talk about this right now. We can talk about it, but this isn't the time. Third thing that I can that I'd like to say is, jealousy is one of those things that can literally sever your relationship in half. It can literally pull you two apart. So if you find yourself prone to jealousy, rather than acting on jealousy and speaking about it, begin to assess what is correct of it and what isn't. And you will find that jealousy is prone from certain things that we as Muslims are asked to repress. Suspicion, inna ba'd al-dhanni, if most of suspicion, much of it, is a sinful thing. So don't be too overly suspicious. It is backbiting about other people. I know where he is, I'm sure he's there, and you call your friend up, and you know, and then your friend gives you advice that's poor. All of that increases your jealousy. Number three, the shaitan. So be careful with the shaitan. Always make your adhkar, ask Allah to cure. And if your jealousy is prone from waswasa, which could be from an obsessive compulsive disorder, it's important to get clinical help and get those things sorted from a clinician, not just from a spiritual remedy. And I hope that's of some benefit to you, inshaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure our hearts from jealousy, and may Allah give us spouses who don't make us overly jealous for no reason. وصلي اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد. السلام عليكم.